गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी हाउ टू सॉल्व द इम्पल्स टर्बाइन और पेल्टन व्हील प्रॉब्लम्स। जनरली दिस प्रॉब्लम कम्स फॉर 10 मार्क्स इन द एग्जाम। नाउ जस्ट सी द वन न्यूमेरिकल। ए पेल्टन व्हील इज टू बी डिजाइन फॉर ए हेड ऑफ 60 मीटर व्हेन रनिंग एट 2000 आरपीएम। द पेल्टन व्हील डेवलप्स 95.647 किलोवाट शाफ्ट पावर। द जेट velocity of the bucket is equal to 0.45 times the velocity of jet. Overall efficiency is given 0.85 and coefficient of velocity is equal to 0.98. Now after reading this numerical, you will have this question that what is to be find in this numerical. So just read the one first line carefully. A Pelton wheel is to be designed. So whenever such word is coming that we have to design something, so remember, in while designing the Pelton wheel, we require the diameter of wheel, that is capital D, diameter of jet, that is small d, width and depth of the bucket, width and depth of the bucket, these things, and the number of buckets on the wheel. These things which we have to find whenever the question comes, like we have to design something. So remember, a Pelton wheel is to be designed, that means we have to find this all five things. Now what is given data? So we will first write what is given. So just see, firstly the design for a head of 60 meter. So head means capital H is given. So capital H is equal to 60 meter. This is given. When running at 2000 RPM, so N is given 2000 RPM. The Pelton wheel develops 95.647 kilowatt. Now this is the power given. So I will use the capital P symbol, which is 95.647 kilowatt. Shaft power, this is the shaft power, so you can write like this also, shaft power. The velocity of bucket is equal to 0.4 times the velocity of jet. Now what is this? Now remember, velocity of bucket, that means bucket are mounted on the runner, that means the velocity of runner is 0.4 times the velocity of jet. Now what is velocity of jet? Whenever the water is coming out of the jet, that means that is the absolute velocity of the water at inlet. So we have relation, velocity of bucket is equal to 0.45 times the velocity of jet, that is u is equal to 0.45 times v1 is given. Now overall efficiency is given 0.85. remember, I'm always telling you, whenever the final answer is given, like efficiency is given, so write the formula in front of that, so that you can understand what we will get from that given value. So what is the overall efficiency? Overall efficiency is nothing but shaft power upon water power. Now shaft power is already given, and what is water power? Water power is nothing but what is the water available and how much is the power available in that water. So that how we are defining rho into g into q into h. So this term I have already explained, rho g q is nothing but the weight of the water, and h is the height, that means for a particular height we have using that water at that head. So this is we have known. So by this you can easily understand, shaft power is given, head is given, so we have to find the discharge by using this. Okay, now lastly, the coefficient of velocity is given 0.98. now coefficient of velocity, as explained earlier, it is CV, and the value of CV normally ranges from 0.8 to 98. So here it is given 0.98. if it is not given, you can assume it. Now this is the given data, and we have to find the capital D, that is diameter of runner, diameter of small d, diameter of jet, width and depth of the bucket, then number of buckets on the runner. So these things we have to find. Now just go step by step. Just remember the things which we have to find, just take a reminder that these comes in which formula? So if you look at, we have U and the V1 relation here, and D is there in the pi D N formula. So we have to find the D by using U formula. So for that we have to find first value of U, and we have a relation this. So the value of CV is given. So CV, by use of CV we can find the value of V1. Once you find V1, we can easily find the value of U. So our first step is to find the value of V1. So V1 is CV into root 2GH. Now remember, I am always telling you, put the values in the formula and then write the answer. Just don't write the formula and directly write the answer. So CV is given 0.98 and root 2G is constant, H is given 60 meter. So after this you will get the answer of V1. You will get the answer of V1 as 33.62 meter per second. Whatever is the answer coming, just make a square to that answer. So once you find this V1, you can find U. We have U is equal to 0.45 times V1. So just put this value here into 33.62. So we will get the value of U as 15.13 meter per second. So this is our another answer. So this is the first step. Now once you find this U, now the next step is, once you find this value of U, you write the formula for U. Now as you are knowing, in case of Pelton wheel, the velocity U1 and U2 is equal to U, we are writing it as. So pi D N upon 60. Now U is known to us, N is given, pi is constant, 60 is constant. So find the value of D. So D we will get as 60 into U upon pi N. Just put all the values, 60 into 15.13 upon pi, and the speed is given 2000. So that we will get the answer of diameter as 1.44 meter. Now you can easily understood that what unit it will come. The U is in meter per second, so automatically your diameter will be in meter. If you are taking your answer of U in centimeter per second, then your diameter will come in centimeter. If you are taking it in mm per second, then your answer will come into mm. So this is the diameter. The first thing we have find, this is our first answer, diameter we have find out. Now we have to find now nextly the diameter of jet, small d. So small d is come into the area of jet formula, and area of jet is coming into the discharge formula. Now here is the discharge. We have to use the concept of continuity equation, that q is equal to area into velocity. Now the discharge coming out of jet is equal to area of jet into velocity coming out of jet. This concept we have to use. So this is our step 3. So firstly write like this, discharge is equal to area of jet into velocity of jet. So these things are given. Now discharge, how we can find the discharge? As I have said earlier, overall efficiency is given. Now overall efficiency is the nothing but shaft power upon water power. So write the formula. Shaft power is given 95.647 divided by, water power is rho g q h. So just put all the answers. 90, and remember this 95.647 is kilowatt. So you have to convert that into, it is given in the kilowatt, so we have to convert it into watt, otherwise our answer will go wrong. Now rho is 1000 as it is water, discharge is unknown, and head is 60, and the overall efficiency is given 0.85. so you can find the discharge using this. The answer of discharge comes 0.1912 meter cube per second. So this is our another answer. Once you find this, just put into the previous formula. Now what is area of jet? It is pi by 4 d1 square into velocity coming out of jet is absolute velocity, so it is v1. Now the only unknown is d, so find the value of d. First find the value of d, so find the value of d1 square. And once you find that d1 square, I will directly writing the answer now. So we will get the answer of d as 0.085 meter, because the answer of q is in meter cube per second, so we will get the answer in meter. You can convert that answer into mm, so it will 85 mm. So this is the diameter of the jet we have get. Now next we have to find third thing, that is the width and depth and width of the bucket. Now you can see the refer the formula list which I have shared in that design of the Pelton wheel. So there are directly relation given that width of bucket is equal to 5 times the diameter of the jet. So just we have to multiply the diameter of jet by 5. So if you multiplying in mm, your answer will be in mm. So this comes 425 mm. So this is our another answer. And the another relation, that is depth of bucket is equal to 1.2 times diameter of jet. So just multiply the diameter of jet by 1.2, our answer will be 102 mm. So this is our another answer. And lastly, we have to find the number of buckets and that is number of buckets on the wheel, and that is denoted by Z. And we have formula for that as 15 plus capital D upon 2D. So we have the diameter of rudder also and diameter of jet also. Now just we have to remember that the unit of both the D should be same. So if you are using the meter for the diameter of rudder, then use same unit for the diameter of jet. So I am using meter as a unit. So 15, our diameter of rudder is 1.44. 2 times what is the diameter of jet? The answer is 0.085. so answer after solving, the answer is coming as 23.5. so the bucket should be not an half answer. So if your answer is coming about the 5, then directly take the next. So it is nearly equal to 24. So answer of Z is 24 buckets. So I think you have understood this. Similar types of numericals are coming. Another type we will see in the next video. Thank you.